Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans, and today I want to bring you the final installment in setting up Live Story Creator, this time using styles within Microsoft Word. So styles allow you to select certain portions of your script and change them into a variety of different actions and instructions within Live Story Creator. So once you have your script configured properly, all you gotta do is hit play in your teleprompter and Live Story Creator will run the entire TriCaster broadcast for you. Now, this video today is gonna be a little bit longer than the other ones I've shown you, but will work in conjunction with them. So, we've got a lot to cover. Let's get down to it. Okay, so before I jump into Microsoft Word and showing you the nitty-gritty details of how to use styles, I wanna just go over some of the fundamentals of what a typical show is going to look like. So, your typical show structure is going to be the show title itself, and then underneath that is where you're going to have your episodes of your show. And within each episode, you're going to have a variety of different scenes, and within those scenes, you'll have different characters, actions, and dialogue. Now, this is going to be true for any show that you're watching, either if it's a news broadcast, a drama, sitcom, etc. So now, we're going to take these fundamentals and go over to Microsoft Word and start adding the styles to run our script. All right, so over here in Microsoft Word, this is the script that I intend to use for my Live Story Creator broadcast. So right now I don't have any styles attached to this particular document right now. It's just a simple script. And before we start to apply those styles, let's go ahead and look at the different elements within the script so that we can start to tag them in the different categories that we want. All right, so first line here is my show title. That is fairly explanatory. That will be our show title. After that is gonna be our episode title. And so that's gonna be the episode from the PowerPoint slide that I just showed y'all. After this, I have the intro segment. We're gonna treat that as a scene. So in this particular script that I'm writing out here, this is going to be a news broadcast, not a drama or a sitcom or anything like that. So we're gonna treat our intro segments as scenes. And then here we have Tommy will be our first character. So we're gonna just say, okay, Tommy's gonna be one of our characters here. And beneath that, this is going to be the dialogue for Tommy. All right, now underneath that will be Candace, that's our second character, and then the different dialogue for her. All right, and then after that, we have Tommy again, and then you see there's a little action here, say with enthusiasm, so that's gonna be an action, and then back to dialogue. Okay. Now, what we're gonna do is on the slide that I showed you, there are different styles within Microsoft Word that will then indicate what that is. So, for example, I say show title up here at the top, but we don't wanna say show title, we wanna actually have our news broadcast. So you can title it whatever you want, and then to access the styles, you're gonna go up here for our styles. So you'll see there's a whole bunch of different ones in here from normal to heading 1, 2, 3, and the list kind of goes on and on. And we're not going to use all of them, only a few of them. But now let's go ahead and look at my next slide to indicate what the styles are going to be for our different bullet points here. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Okay, now in this slide, I highly recommend taking a screenshot of this so that we can look at it later. But within Microsoft Word, we're going to look at those same bullet points of show, episode, scene, character, action, and dialogue, and then start to apply the styles within Microsoft Word to those particular categories. So, next to show, we have title, and then episode will be heading number 1, scene will be heading 2, character is heading 3, action is subtitle, and then dialogue is normal, so we won't have to do anything for that. Okay, so now let's move back over to Word and start to apply those to these particular subjects. Okay, so back in Microsoft Word, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna start to highlight these different elements and apply those styles to them, okay? So the first one, our show title, let me go ahead and highlight that, and we're gonna go ahead and select title for that, and as soon as you do that, you'll notice automatically that the font changes and also the size of that changes as well, and that's just for the title. All right, now we're gonna go to the next one, which is gonna be our episode title. And let's go ahead and find what corresponds to that, which is gonna be heading number one. So we'll click heading one here. And you'll notice that changes as well. So then after that, we're gonna go through and find our scene, which is this one here. And that's gonna correspond to heading number two. Right, and you'll see every time I do this, it changes the script just a little bit as far as like what it looks like. All right, now next, let's go through and find our characters here. So here is Tommy, and to designate that the name that you're using here is going to be a character, we need to choose heading three up here at the top. All right. And then for the dialogue part of things, this is the one that we can leave normal. We don't have to do any styling to this. So you'll see up here at the top, it literally says normal. So I'll click on that and it'll just change it to my normal text. All right, so let's keep going down our script here. We'll go to Candace, and for her, for a character, again, we need to use heading three. And let's go ahead and select all of her dialogue and just make that normal. All right, and now let's go down the script here a little bit more, and we'll go to Tommy's next line, and we'll select Tommy, and characters are again heading three, and then we get to his first direction here, say with enthusiasm. So for that, we need to use the subtitle style within Microsoft Word. So we'll go to the top of the screen here, and click through our styles until we find subtitle. There it goes. Cool, and again, you'll see that it's changing the font of that. And now let's go ahead and make sure that that is selected as normal for Tommy's additional dialogue. All right, now here's where we get to a different part of our script where there is a new scene. So this is gonna be the sports segment. So again, we'll go and according to the slide that I just showed you, we'll go ahead and select heading two for that. All right, and here is our coach. So we need to select him as a character. So we'll check heading three and go through his dialogue, make sure that's normal. And just to kind of speed through this real quick, I'm just going to go ahead and just highlight these where they need to be. So character, again, is three. Dialogue's normal. I know this is a bit tedious, but so is writing a script, right? All right, so we'll go ahead and do that. Sure that's normal. Tommy's there. And back to that. And we'll kind of just stop here. All right, cool. Well, there's more dialogue at the bottom here because it's more of a page. Okay, so now we have our scripts with all of our different styles applied to it. So now let's go ahead and I'm going to send this over and save it and pull it up on my TriCaster. All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 where we're gonna pull all of this together. So I've made this a very simple show today. We're only dealing with our three different characters, which I have assigned to my mix effect number one, two, and three, and they're all on their respective virtual sets. Some simple stuff I'm doing here, but you get the idea. All right, and then I also have my script loaded into input six so that I can route that to one of my outputs, which I've shown in a previous video. Highly recommend checking that out if you don't know how to do that. Okay, so with our script that we have in here, remember that it does use some built-in artificial intelligence to start to manipulate and run our show for us. So there's a few things that we need to go through and do. And the first thing is we need to let our TriCaster know who our characters are. Because if I get down here to my script to where it reaches Tommy, it doesn't know who Tommy is. It's just a TriCaster. So let's kind of fill in those gaps. So to do that, we'll rename our particular inputs that we're going to use here. So I'll go over into mix effect number one, click on that gear icon for that. And in this pop-up, this allows me to rename my connection here. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna say, let's rename our video number one name to Tommy. We'll leave the button the same, but then here is an option to bring in comments, and I am going to leave that one blank, or sorry, not blank, but leave this particular dialogue in here for the time being, and you'll see why when we get to it. All right, now let's go ahead and change, when we did that, so you'll notice that the name for our particular source has now been updated. So let's go ahead and do the same thing for our mix effect number two. And from here, I'm going to type in Candice. And for our comments, let's go ahead and put in a city. So we'll put San Antonio, Texas. All right, and do that. And again, our input name for mix effect two has been updated. And now let's go into my mix effect number three, and we're gonna change that to Coach. And we're gonna say Austin, Texas for him, all right? Cool. So the only one that doesn't have a comment in here indicating their city is Tommy up here in a bit. So keep that in mind as we go along. All right, so now not only does Live Story Creator go through and change the actions and switch between different sources within the TriCaster, but it also allows you to manage different graphic elements. So to do that, let's go ahead and throw up one of our live graphics into our buffer number one here. So I'll click on this plus button and go ahead and I'm gonna select this one just from default. One of our live graphics here. All right, let's go ahead and I'm going to set that to off for the time being. All right, so now we have our live graphic on screen right now, but it's currently set to off until we need it. All right, so the next thing that we need to do is load up our script. So this script that I have in here before, this was just the regular old script before I did any of the styling changes to it. So I've already went ahead and saved that particular script. So to load it back in, all we have to do is click on this button here and it will reload our scripts. Let's go ahead and do that. All right, so it's loading in our scripts. And boom, check it out. Now our script has changed just a little bit after we added some of those styles to it. So let's go ahead and go through this before we go ahead and run our broadcast. So you'll see, first of all, that our show title is going to appear here in yellow, and that's just basically saying this is the beginning of our show on the automation side of things. And that will appear on your teleprompter output. But you will see that next, within the script that we had previous, we also had an option for our episode and our scene, which do not appear in this particular option here. But it's gonna be managing our graphics and also what encapsulates inside of a scene. So again, remember, so inside of a scene, you have your characters, actions, and your dialogue. And within each scene, then the scene is gonna be encapsulated by an episode, and then an episode is gonna be encapsulated by your show title. So please reference those slides that I showed earlier because that will help. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start my scripts, and let's go ahead and see what happens. I'm going to stop the script from playing every now and then just to kind of point out a few things that have happened. So let's go ahead, I'm gonna switch over here to one of these other inputs, like input number 11, and pretend that this is gonna start from black and just go straight into our show. So we'll go ahead and hit play here at the bottom of our Live Story Creator Automation tab scripts, and here we go. So the first thing that's gonna happen is it is gonna bring up our show title via our live graphics. So it has a show title and our episode title, so that'll be our title and heading number one, and you'll see that there's a blue bar here indicating when that will go away. And then here we go to Tommy, and check out his lower third, first thing. So it has his name here in the live graphics, but then also a comment here, which is what I left blank over on his particular mix effect. So let's go ahead and let's change that real fast. And we'll do that for Houston, Texas. All right, so now whenever we fire off his lower third again, it will go ahead and put his city that he's from. Now in doing so, keep in mind that within a scene, normally like during a news broadcast like this, whenever you introduce a character, you will go ahead and switch to their source like it just did by indicating his name and then brought up his lower third. But if we end up going back to him in the same scene, it will not bring up his lower third because we've already established who Tommy is. Okay, so let's go ahead and keep going through our script real quick. And I'm not gonna read that off because I got things to do. But what's gonna happen next is as we go along, our next host right here, Candice, is coming up. So her text is in white, and so check this out. It's gonna go ahead and switch over to mix effect number two on our program and bring up her lower third. Boom, and has her name and that comment that we had in there. and then it will fade away, bring that off screen. So we've established who Candace is. All right, so now we're gonna go back to Tommy, and you'll see here that before I get there, I'm gonna stop this real quick, that I have an action on screen to say with enthusiasm. So this yellow is going to indicate the action that I had available to him, which again, on the styling side of things, was our subtitles. So subtitles will appear on screen in yellow, whereas the names are gonna be black text in a white box. All right, now we've already established who Tommy was, so we're gonna go ahead and just switch to him, but his graphic is not gonna appear on screen. So let's go ahead and do that. And then it just goes over to Tommy. All right, so he's gonna start talking about our coach that's gonna be showing up here. And let me stop our script here for just a moment. So you'll mention, if I take a look back at the script that we had, that I had a section where when our coach shows up, that we're gonna be going over to the sports segment. So when doing so, I basically have just reset the scene. So when I've reset the scene, now I've also reset the graphics that are within said scene. So let's go ahead and hit play here, and we'll go to coach's part. So it'll go over to coach and bring up his lower third and where he's from, Austin, Texas. All right, now since I did switch to a different scene here, check this out. My next source is gonna go over to Candace, and since this is a new scene, it was gonna bring up her lower third again. So check this out. Go over to Candace here and ta-da, there we go. There is our graphic coming back. And if I go back to coach, since he's still in the same scene, that's not gonna bring in his lower third. So switch back over to coach, and we're good to go. It just so switches back to him without that particular graphic. So keep that in mind whenever you are doing your graphics within here, is that the lower thirds are going to be separated by the different scene segments, which are again, heading number two. Highly recommend just go ahead and using that cheat sheet. That's what's been helping me to get through all of this. So if we go back to Tommy, he's in the same scene, and here comes his lower third. And so it switches, brings on his lower third again, and then that will fade off. So tons of different things you can do with Live Story Creator. I've given you a whole, you know, barrage of ammunition to go through and start to mess around with this. So using it as a regular teleprompter is great. Using the comment sections in Microsoft Word is great. And then also using the different styles within Microsoft Word is great as well. So I highly recommend combining all of those different methodologies, putting them together and start playing around with it, and you can really create some awesome, wonderful stuff. All right, so as you can see, there are a lot of cool methods that you can use with Live Story Creator to run your show. There's no one way to do this, and everyone's workflows are gonna be a little bit different, but no matter how you configure Live Story Creator, you're going to end up with some pretty cool results. Now, to find out more information about Live Story Creator, talk to your local reseller or visit newtek.com. You can also find more tutorial videos like this one available on our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtekinc. And also be sure to visit newtek.tv to stay in touch with all the latest news and interviews about NewTek products. Well, thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.